Jai Jinendra all, today we are going to talk about the what is the ajeev and how the ajeev differs from the jeev. So anything that does not have life or consciousness is called ajeev. Ajeev is literally means without a soul, which therefore they cannot accumulate any karmas, right? So they have no pleasure, no pain, and they are achet. So example of ajeev, we are surrounding by many ajeev things in our surrounding. Like you can consider a box or a car, table, chair, everything you can consider. Most of the things, like not everything, but most of the things we can call ajeev, which we are surrounding by, human or jeev things are surrounded by. So is anybody know that our body is also ajeev? Yeah, so that is true. Ajeev, the body is called the ajeev. And when the soul is in your body, it makes you jeev. So you can feel, you can taste or anything. So without soul, the body is, we call ajeev. The universe is made of six eternal substances, and out of these six substances, the five are pudgal, dharmastikai, adharmastikai, akas and kal. So we will talk about these five in more detail. So first, let's go with the pudgal. So what is pudgal? So pudgal is nothing. In science, we learn about matter, right? So pudgal is constituted of atom, which can be perceived by the senses, right? So karmic matter are also we can consider as a pudgal, right? So any material substance which always comes together and separate apart, so that's called the pudgal. Pudgal has four properties like color, taste, smell and spurs, we call touch, right? So all these property pudgal has. Out of these six substance, the pudgal only, pudgal has a visible and they have a form. So this is the one property. And if you can consider the next side, the pudgal, the whatever we are seeing surrounding us in ajeev world, right, that is called skand. So that is called entire material object, like chair is one, is the one object, but we can see that, right? So that's called the skand. Skand is the portion of the object, like this chair has one leg, if you consider, that is called a desh. Skand pradesh, or more granular level, smaller portion of object, we can call skand pradesh. And finally, the smallest particle of that object, we call parmanu, a smallest unit of matter, right? So do you know that our Kevali Bhagwan, he is only who can see the parmanu in science. Currently still searching and keep changing what is the smallest unit of any object, like quark or boson. So we are still, science is still working on that, and our Kevali Bhagwan is know that parmanu. Second, we talk about dharmastikai and adharmastikai. It is a medium of motion in which jeev and pudgal are move. Without dharmastikai, jeev and pudgal cannot move. And even when they want, without dharmastikai, jeev and pudgal cannot move, even they want to move. Because of dharmastikai, jeev and pudgal move in a different direction, like udvar disha or adho disha, right? So pure soul, like a Siddha Bhagwan soul, which are the pure, so they always move to the Urdhva Disha and reach to Siddha Sila, where dharmastikai end. And some of this soul which moves to the Adho Disha to reach the seventh Narki. So dharmastikai and adharmastikai, I will continue on that to discuss a little more. When soul moves, there must be some medium of the rest, right? So if there is no rest, everything will move. There is something is fraction or something is required which can reduce the speed or reduce the motion of the soul. So for that, this is use the adharmastika, which is called motion of the rest, which slow down or stop the soul to move further, right? So adharmastika prevail in lok and it is absence in the alok, right? So
akas,
what is akas? So we know that akas means that place where jiv and ajiv are accommodated, right? So we see in our day to we as a jiv and also a jiv like chair, table are accommodated in the same space, right? Which call akas. Akas has both accommodated jiv and ajiv. There are two type of akas. One is a lokakas and another is alokakas, right? Jiv, pudgal, dharmastikai and adharmastikai exist only in a lokakas, right? So in diagram, we can see that in diagram that lokakas present in a black color portion and alokakas is present in the yellow color part. So kal, what is kal? The next property is kal. What is kal? Kal is the merely the measure of your time over which changes occurs, right, in our life. In Jainism, very tiny measurement of a time is known as a samay. There are many examples in our life, like you purchase a book when it's new, you see the color of the pages, right, that the white, but eventually slowly every samay in Jainism, every samay the pages is changing by their color or by their thickness or anything. So the same way the life, right? The kid is born and day by day, means samay by samay, it will change his course, his looks is changing, but we cannot see each and every samay because it's a very tiny portion, tiny measurement, but eventually or day by day we can see the improvement of kid, how he become older and then finally died, right? So kal table, right? So we told that the smallest measure in our Jainism is samay. So if we enumeration of samay we make together, which in Jainism we call one avali. The what is avali? That in real world we can that if a time requires to blink an eye. So when you blink an eye, what is enumeration samay which pass away with that. One Muhurat is like 48 minutes, right? So we do our samayik also a 48 minutes, right? So the other things we can self-explanatory that 30 Muhurat is called one day. What is 5 years? 5 years is one yuga. 8.4 million into 8.4 million years equal to one purva, right? So why I mention that? Because our Rushabdev Bhagwan, our first Tirthankar Ayushya is 8.4 million year purva. So innumerable years is called Paliyopam. Paliyopam, when we 10 into 10 million into 10 million is called one Sagropam, right? So and 10 into 10 million into 10 million Sagropam equal to ours Avsarpini and Ussarpini, right? So and if we multiply by 20 into 10 million into 10 million Sagropam, it call one time cycle, we call one Kal Chakra. According to Jainism, day by day the sorrow will increase when the progressive descending stage and happening increase in each progressing ascending stage. So So currently we are a fifth era. We you see that in the world right now, people are not happy, or people are not not getting enough from these years. So which they used to get during earlier years. So this is the one of the very good this video I found in a YouTube, which I want to share with you guys.
Does the act of buying things actually bring happiness? You've probably heard of Marie Kondo.
Hello, I'm Marie Kondo.
She's the organizing consultant changing the way people all over the world think about their stuff by asking the question, does this spark joy?
Choose item that spark joy for you.
Spark joy. If it does, you keep it. If it doesn't, you declutter it. What's decluttering? Decluttering is the process of spreading out all your stuff on the floor and deciding what should stay and what should go. What if we're asking the wrong question? What if instead of asking, does this spark joy once the thing is in your house, we ask, will this spark joy before you buy it? In other words, does the act of buying things actually bring happiness? That's the question one professor set out to answer. She learned that people who were found to be more materialistic associated future purchases with strong, positive emotions. The mere thought of buying things sparked feelings of joy and excitement, regardless of whether they were thinking of buying a car or a toaster. Get this, after they bought the thing, they experienced what was called a hedonic decline. A hedonic decline is when repeated exposure to a stimulus reduces a person's pleasure. It's kind of like eating candy every day. The first couple days, you're like... But after a week, you're like... So the study concludes that wanting something and buying it makes people happy. But after the purchase, when you actually own the thing, it does not spark joy. So what does spark joy? Well, studies show that the act of giving actually brings much more joy and satisfaction than the act of getting. When people focus on an outcome, like getting paid or buying stuff, they fall into a comparison mindset, where they become unhappy because they're comparing themselves with other people. But when people focus on an action, like donating to charity or volunteering, they compare less and instead experience each act of giving as a unique happiness-inducing event. So how about, instead of buying a jacket because you want one, give a jacket to someone who needs one. This is the type of joy that will last long after you've uploaded your outfit of the day on Instagram. The best time to ask if something sparks joy isn't after you've had it, but before you buy it.
What we learned from this video is the less I have, the more I am. So, or more I'm happy that I'm giving something, and that will make my soul more happy. So that Param Pujya Acharya Yashovide Suri Maharaj Sahib told us that is our Pathshala, one of the motto we can consider that we should follow in our life. So the second thing is, I'm thinking that replace the lobe with the Santosh Gun. So whatever we are getting, we should Santosh ourselves, then that way we will improve ourselves day by day. So most of our physical pleasure are ajiv. I include our body, right? Body is also ajiv. So we like our body, well maintain our body, right? So that is, we are spending more our time for our ajiv thing. Knowing this, here's my goal, that limit the 5 dravyas to purchase on tithis if it's required. I should go to the zero, limit to zero, but I put myself as a 5 dravya to limit myself if required, but my goal should go to the zero, right? And second thing is dhyan abhyas. I will learn to dhyan so I can go to the deeper, to my nature, to understand myself better. And to get this better, better at jnan, I will do swadhyay, so that I can learn more about tattvas.